The markets, when the COVID-19 kind of hit in late February, the markets didn't want to give up its bull run, its 11-year bull run. But as we started to see signs of that bull run ending, we started to see liquidations in late February and early March. The S&P 500 retreated roughly 35% in that first major drawdown. I believe it ended on March 23rd, the first drawdown. From that point, we have rallied back about 25% on the S&P 500. So it's been a really strong rally based on some hints of good news. The bull market run that we were on was probably the longest we've seen in U.S. history. As we started to see the markets drop, we also started to see the mandated quarantine or the shutting down of businesses. So when we value companies, we use earnings. And with no clear sight as to what earnings would look like with companies being shut down, there was, if we don't have the data to make the calculations, then we assume, markets tend to assume. We tend to think that we're forming a bottom, or bottoming of the market is a process. So history would support that since we've had the recent rally, we'll probably see an additional decline. And it kind of depends on what the picture, what the future picture of the economy looks like. Patience is really what it comes down to. We're thinking that we see positive growth by fourth quarter. I think for additional upside, we need to see more meaningfully positive news. And right now, we're just operating on the hints of positive news. So I think the story will develop, but the market has been resilient historically, and we've come through these times in a positive fashion over the longer period.